This is it. We're going to unbox the electronics lab kit. All right, let's see what we got in here. Thank you for BJ for packing all this stuff. Looks good. All right, what do we have? We have our kit of components with a label here on the front. Inside the kit of components, we have capacitors and miscellaneous capacitors, diodes, LEDs, switches, buttons, transistors, transistors of various kinds, various chips. These are OpAmps, digital logic chips, microphone, speaker, headphone inputs here. We have light bulbs and big resistors. We have potentiometers, which are variable resistors. We have battery, motor, a little microcontroller board, which we'll use toward the end, a little hobby servo, a fuse for your multimeter in case something goes wrong. All the contents are labeled here. All right, set that aside. This is the oscilloscope power supply function generator module. Very important. Let's open this one up, show you what it looks like. This device here plugs into USB. Should be a USB cable in here. Yep, here's the USB cable. And you plug these probes in and you use it to probe your circuit. Let's do that quickly. So here's where the probes plug in. For now, we'll only use the smaller of the two probes. This is mostly for digital. We'll do this toward the end. So the smaller of the two probes plugs in first. And what's labeled here are the various oscilloscope channels and function generator channels and power supply channels. Here are the outputs of those. USB cable plugs in the back here. There are two USBs. One is just for extra power in case you need it, and this is to plug into the computer and supply a reasonable amount of power. So we'll just plug into the computer, supply a reasonable amount of power. Got a computer, I plug that in. Okay, looks good, setting that aside. We have a resistor kit. Let's take a look at what's in the resistor kit. It is all kinds of resistors. They are all in individual bags and labeled. So R is like the decimal point. So 1R means 1 ohm, 1.2 ohms, 3.3 ohms, all the way up to 220 ohms. Here we go, 1.2 kilo ohms, 2.7 kilo ohms, 12 kilo ohms, 56 kilo ohms, 100 kilo ohms. Let's see, 820. Our biggest resistor here at the very end is 1 mega ohm. There are actually 10 mega ohm resistors in your kit, 1 mega ohm. In addition to the bags, there's a whole little card on how to read the resistors here. This is your breadboard. So the important thing about the breadboard is you always hold it in what looks like sideways, like this. So there are these long rows here. There are two long rows and then vertical columns of five. Two more long rows, vertical columns of five. Each of these are connected. So this very top row is connected all the way across. The next row is connected all the way across. And these are connected in little columns of five. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then these are all connected columns of five. So if I see you holding it like this, it's gonna be confusing and awkward, even though it looks like that's how you should hold it, like this. Okay, what else do we have? Extra USB cable. This is mostly for the, either to power your board through an external power supply if you have it, or more likely for the microcontroller toward the end of the class. We'll use this USB cord. This is a, I believe this is a, yes, screwdriver, mini screwdriver. Lots of different options here. Some of the audio stuff requires screwdriving. This is a wire stripper and a wire cutter, and that is for your kit of wires here. So everyone has a different kit of wires. Sometimes it might look different. I don't love these kits because the colors are coded by the length. I would say that what's much more important is to have the colors mean something. So have black mean ground, have red mean power supply. And that's what the little stripper is for. So you don't actually have any black wires in this one, at least, but there are some different colors here. You could choose to use gray or brown as ground if you want. So there's some wires. You can cut and strip with this to make more clean edges. So this one is a new kit, so it started out as all clean edges. Some of you might have less new kits. This is a component tester. So let me open up this. I'll show you what it looks like. Different ones of you have different versions of these kits. This is the kit that you assemble. Most of you have something that needs assembly. So you peel the brown backing off of these clear things. And there's some hardware here, and you can figure out how to puzzle it together. It'll take you, I don't know, 10 or 15 minutes. And the result should look something like this, a component tester. And you can stick components in here. I don't know if you could see it's labeled pins 1, 2, 3, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. So all the ones are all connected together, and 2 and 3 are different options here. So if you hit the button, it says it's a tester, it's testing. So right now there's no part in there, so it just says unknown part. What is this? These are some extra wires that are useful for plugging things into your circuit board, into your breadboard, but also for going from that logic analyzer USB thing. Sorry, the oscilloscope USB thing. This is a logic probe. This is for when we get into the digital part of the lab. You clip the red and the black clips on power and ground. On your the power and ground that you're supplying to your breadboard, and then you can probe around with this little point here, and you can say is it logic high, logic low, logic high, logic low. Are there different flavors of logic, TTL versus CMOS, and there are different a switch here to remember if there was a very brief pulse, do you want it to just pulse very briefly, or do you want to show that pulse? That's what the logic probe is. Finally, there's a multimeter. You all have different versions of this multimeter. We use it almost exclusively for voltage, sometimes resistance, very rarely for measuring current, because that's more dangerous here. So if you measure voltage, turn to the voltage setting. We've supplied you with these type of probes, which are just wires on the end, so COM, and if you're measuring volts or ohms, you plug it into this one. And if I were to measure the voltage here, I should get 0 volts. There we go, 0 volts. If I were to measure the resistance here, right now it's overload, that's what OL means. And if I hold these together, it should go down to pretty low, 0.2 ohms, so that's the resistance of the wire. There are different versions. It's very useful to have a continuity tester, which is just another kind of resistance meter. So if I do shift here, shows this sort of like, I don't know, speakers or Wi-Fi type symbol here. And if I touch things together and there's an electrical connection, it will beep. If you measure a current, you have to plug the red wire into one of these two current meter readings here. So if I were to measure 20 amps, which is the safest thing to measure, it sort of maxes out at 20 amps, which means nothing you can generate. Nothing you have can generate 20 amps, so it's pretty safe. You plug it in here, and then you probe various parts of your circuit. All right, turn it off to save battery. Last thing that's in here is a list of all the things that are in your kit, so that if you send it back at the end of the semester, you have the whole list. And that is it. That is our unboxing video. Thanks.